Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today we're going to talk about Gmail attachment size limits and how to send large files over email. Whether you're delivering important documents or just sharing photos from a family vacation, sending attachments should be a breeze. However, the Gmail attachment size limit, which is 25 megabytes, can make this process a bit difficult. In this video, I'm going to show you four simple ways to send large files over email. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, let's get to it. Cloud storage is a way to save your files off-site on a server that you can access from anywhere, as long as you have an internet connection. It also means that you can use cloud storage to give people access to your files. All you have to do is upload the document to the cloud and send a link to your recipients. There are plenty of programs that offer this service. At Kinsta, we're big fans of Google Drive. Let's take a quick look at how you can use this tool to share large files like videos. First, navigate to Google Drive. In the upper left corner, click the New button. You'll now see a few options. You can either create the document here or upload your own. Afterward, go to the document you want to share. In the upper right corner, click the Share button. Here, you can add people to the document. They'll receive an invitation and be able to access your file. Alternatively, you can copy the URL and send the link to them via email. Another way you can bypass an attachment size limit is through compression. Most computers enable you to turn a document into a zip file. Zipped files are compressed versions of your documents. Typically, these are smaller than regular files. Your recipients can easily unzip the file when they receive it to get back to the original file. Creating a zipped file is a simple process. Start by locating the file you want to compress. Then, right-click it and select Send to Compress Folder. Once you've done that, you'll get the compressed file in a zipped folder. However, bear in mind that compression can only do so much. It typically reduces the size by about 30 to 40%, but depending on the original file size, it might not be enough. If you're still unable to meet your email attachment size limit, you might want to try the following method. Fortunately, many free tools can help you circumvent file size limits when sending emails. Some of these might even compress your files further or allow you to use their servers to send a separate email. Nevertheless, these free services might come with a few drawbacks. For instance, you might have to navigate a few ads to use a tool. Additionally, some tools might have size limits of their own. Furthermore, some services are less secure than others. Therefore, we advise against using this method if you're sending sensitive information. However, encryption can help lower the risk of having your data stolen. When it comes to a reliable online file sharing tool, we recommend JumpShare. JumpShare enables you to upload large files and send them directly to other people. It also generates links to these files. The free version of JumpShare has a file upload limit of 250 megabytes, which is far more generous than the Gmail attachment size limit. Moreover, the program uses secure sockets layers to protect your data during transfers. Splitting your files can be tedious. As such, we only recommend using this method if you need to send one document. Simply put, you'll need to divide a multi-page document into several individual documents and send several emails, possibly one for each attachment. There are some significant drawbacks to this approach. The most obvious one is that your information will be segmented, and the recipient will have to reassemble it on their own. Fortunately, you can use a tool like GSplit to simplify this process. GSplit is a free program that automatically divides your work into manageable chunks. Even better, it helps you put it back together. Your recipients can use its companion tool, GUnit, to reassemble your files. Nevertheless, this method can make you look unprofessional. Therefore, we suggest that you only use it for personal purposes. Do you have further questions about bypassing the Gmail attachment size limit? Let us know in the comments below. If you're looking to boost your site's organic traffic and beat out your competition, then we have the perfect ebook for you. Download our free Ultimate Guide to SEO ebook to gain access to the 50 plus tips we used to grow our own organic traffic by more than 123% year over year. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.